All right. If I remember correctly, yeah, we gotta do some work. I'm gonna have to go farm wither skeletons after this. I don't have a wither farm. Slightly concerning that I have never fought a wither before. I'm sure it'll be fine. Or at least I've never fought a wither before in Java. I have in Bedrock. Which is the harder version, so... away from the diagonal. Hey, blood. No, that is perfectly fine. You're under no obligations. At least not to me. I am out of bricks. Okay. When I initially conceptualized my that is perfectly all right, blood. Guess he wouldn't break with that long. Yeah. What was I gonna say? Oh yeah. So original plans for the base kind of got derailed. Maybe a lot. So originally this thing was going to be like multiple layers. And it was going to go like all the way down to bedrock. Or whatever. But you wouldn't believe how much work it is doing all this. It took me like a year just to finish the first floor. So... that plan was scrapped. I always saw my base as kind of like a little bit of everything. I was gonna have different places for different farms and such, but my base was also just gonna have everything as well. Sometimes it's difficult coming up with like good base ideas for rooms and other things. Like having the essentials is always good, but you don't want to just turn everything into a storage room. So you gotta have, like, all the farm rooms and everything. But then you gotta build all the farm rooms, and that can... That can just be, like, exhausting. Also, I don't want my base to lag, so I'm not going to be using a lot of automatic farms here. It's kind of incredible how much, like, having a tall ceiling adds to the space of a room. Because without the tall ceilings, like, down here doesn't feel like it's very big, you know? But having the tall ceilings, when those eventually get put in, it's just gonna feel even better. I did 100% get sidetracked from my project of draining an ocean monument, which I really should be working on, but I just really wanted to do this, I guess. Also, draining an ocean monument isn't super fun. So, like, I do it in little amounts, you know? The progress is still progress. I'm not too worried about finishing the ocean monument part. Because realistically, that entire endeavor is to get sea lanterns, which is for the city. But I actually gotta build, like, buildings in the city as well. Blocking a beacon. That'd probably be a good thing to know. Earlier this week, I was kind of freaking out about the song upload for the jukebox this week, because I was realizing that releasing a song every single week is a lot of songs. Like, it's an absurd number of songs. I don't make one song a week. I have most of these songs already made, and then sometimes I give them little touch-ups or something, but... Most of these songs are just, like, ready to be uploaded already, but I'm running out of songs that are just ready to be uploaded. So I just started having a little bit of a crisis, like, what am I gonna do when I inevitably run out? I'm gonna have to dial back uploads. you could argue that I've been going for like a quantity over quality approach to my songs. And I would say that in the beginning that was true, but as I got better at making songs and fixing songs, I would say that it more so became about just uploading songs I felt comfortable with uploading, as opposed to simply uploading them because I felt I had to, with a lot of RSV1 was that way. So I'm gonna be happy when I can just not worry about quality control for the songs and mostly just focus on the pictures. I think certain pictures are definitely way better than others. Like, I'm not happy with the picture for Sticks and Stones at all. I think that one's by far the worst one. And that's mostly just because the lines are very rough, the background isn't very detailed. It was rushed, and I think you can tell. That one might get a re-upload just so I cannot look at that garbage anymore. I feel like a lot of people's first impressions of me would just be like, what is this guy doing? Which they're not wrong for saying that, but, or asking that, I guess. I'm just a simple cat trying to make my way through the universe. Tiles, and so do you. And half of you can become chiseled. And the other half can become polished. And we'll roll with that for now. We still have one whole stack of cobble, so if we need to, we can. Let's go with that. Yeah. You know, I think I used to hate lanterns. That's not true. I just thought they weren't very useful. because they cost way too much iron to craft. But you can just buy them from the store. Also, I have infinite iron now. Because I have an iron farm. Or two, technically, so... I kind of like the valley becoming industrialized, Iron Valley. I think that's just cool. And since it's the spot of my main base, progress that's made here is much more notable than progress that's made other places. I'm out of lanterns. I need to go buy some. That needs to be 5, huh? And then 1, 2, 3. And then 2. And then we'll deal with the rest as we get there. But first, we'll take this. I really want to, like, actually do stuff with Cattail, just in general, but I haven't gotten around to it. I've just been running on low energy this entire year so far, I guess. Same old story if I had a lot of plans going into it, and I had a schedule I was going to work upon, but we haven't gotten that far yet. Not sound like it, but the end of summer got a huge glow up from its original version. And I mean like a huge glow up. It's one of the only songs I can think of that doesn't really have any motifs in it, like at all. It really just does its own thing. When I make music, I focus a lot on the motifs, typically trying to fit a lot into a single song. in a way that, like, makes sense thematically. That's probably my greatest weakness when it comes to making songs, is that I feel like there has to be a thematic relevance. Even in random songs, there has to be a thematic relevance. And that's why the end of summer is so weird. And it's really unlike everything else. I think it and Eternal Symphony are the two most unique songs I've ever made. Oh, and this one also got a huge glow up. Like, a massive glow up. This is debatably my oldest, one of my oldest songs. Well, it's not the oldest. It's like one of the three oldest. I need by lanterns. I don't mean debatable. It is one of my oldest. My honor. Be smart, Cattail. Being dumb is for dumb people. Oh my goodness. I'll need to come back for these pumpkins. Nice having like a billion iron blocks on hand. We're gonna need them too, because we're gonna be making that beacon. This is why it pays to have a pumpkin farm. Look at my pickaxe durability. Is it priests who sell lanterns? All those villagers just jealously looking at that chest. let's repair my shovel as well. Trading games. Good game design, though. Like, genuinely. It's just really fun. Work at your tables. Discounts. I mean, I could scoop up some more options. Nobody needs this many flowers. To the bone meal compressor you go. If I ever need bone meal, I know where to find it. Oh, right, I need pink. I can go pick that up eventually. For now, though. You know, actually thinking about it, the extended versions of songs, I have no idea how to release them. I'm gonna do a new picture for them, but like, when do I want to release them? Obviously not the same time as the original, I guess, but... I know there's a cave around here somewhere. I'm going to run into it. And by a cave, I mean like an actual cave and not the one, the little like corridor thing I ran into. So, a couple fun facts about this song, I guess, are that, one is that originally the plan was for it to have no motifs whatsoever. That was obviously changed, so that basically the entire thing is motifs. But the original plan was that it wasn't going to have any. The other original plan was that the non-extended version of this song only have 4 segments and not 6. You can actually hear that in the other variants of this song that I haven't fixed, where only 4 segments are present in the non-extended versions. And there's a lot of different variants of this song that kind of got melded together into this one. Like, part of the end bit comes from another version of this one. Like, the final segment has the whole drop part before the final. Before the final drop, there's the build-up to it. That wasn't in it originally. That was from a different version of this song. Certain melodies weren't in this song at all originally, and were added in later. Honestly, the history of that song is one of the most interesting and intricate out of any of my songs. And I'm happy I finally actually released a version of it I'm happy with. Seems right. I'm already full on top. You're kidding me. That's 64 already. Well, I'd never have to worry about cobble again, I guess. I should probably also put down some of the chains, just so I have an idea of where the chains are supposed to go. Because it'd be kind of awkward if I just didn't put them anywhere. Still have so much to go. But on the bright side, we're almost done with the rim. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to finish with the rim. I'm going to gear up for the nether. And we're going to go to a fortress. And I'm going to try and get some wither skulls. I didn't put one over here. Come on. You never realize just how big a space is until you start mining it out. Oh, potentially tomorrow I will be starting a new Minecraft series. This series will still be on Mondays, but potentially tomorrow, I don't know. But definitely just on Tuesday nights, for a much shorter stream time, I will be playing with a couple friends, not the Legends, and we will be starting our own Minecraft world and working together. And all that fun stuff. Teamwork and cooperation and all that jazz. So if you want to see me get absolutely bodied by mobs, that would probably be the stream you want to watch. Or the series you'd want to watch, I guess. This is just a much more casual series. That's just me having fun and goofing off. Also a song that's very old, but I don't think this one really needs to be changed. Like, maybe a little bit for the percussion you'll hear in a sec, but other than that, I think it's pretty all good. Thank you. is enough space in the inventory. Very convenient. There we go. That's the rim. Now to figure out where the chains go. So there's one in front of those. Then one that would be here. I don't know how to calculate this distance. But two in front of these ones. What else have we got? Diagonal and then right here. Alright. It's very convenient that I put all these spaced so that they're very close to like the actual ones. So four to the side, and then one in. Okay.
Away.
Then let's gear up. All these chests back here are full, right? Yep. Double chest worth and almost a ninth. good, you know? Diorite and andesite granite go over here. Diorite. Did I call it andesite? It's andesite. Sign and stairs and slabs. I need those rockets. I need my Kingsguard shield and my sword. That's exactly 64, it's very convenient. Oh, this goes in the storage box. I do have soul speed on this. I do need redstone. This one has been filled. Alright. Three water bottles, nether wart. Potion acquired. Fire res. I wish potions still had their glint. Disappointing that they don't. It just feels wrong. Also, brewing should totally give you XP. Okay. Thank you. understand why I have to do that, but the game wants me to have to do that, so I will. For a little killing spree. No, this doesn't lead to the... That leads to the end. That's not where the Nether Fortress is. The Nether Fortress isn't over here. Where's the Nether Fortress? The heck did the fortress go? Here it is. Okay. Honestly, I don't really want to bother with blazes. Looking for the wither skellies. Can't believe I forgot to swap my chest plate. Whoa! That was my shovel. the heck are the Wither Skellies? Are the Wither Skeletons? It's like one. There's just no Wither Skeletons around here. I think I have one Wither Skull. There's like 10 blazes and no Wither Skellies. There's some. to get a giant magma cube. No wither skeletons. Finally. Now I see 3 more. Dude. I probably shouldn't stand on the edge just in case I get attacked from behind. I don't want to mess with you guys. Got like 2 minutes left to fire res. All that for one wither skull. I see a wither skelly though. Really don't need a gas messing everything up. Yes, I have two skulls. All right. Yeah. Well, we got two skulls. I know there's a way to get home from here. I just need to remember. Ah, so it's above the pathway. Okay. Well, we found two skulls. Perhaps next stream we can kill a wither. Our plate actually got some use, look at that. I should just go buy a bunch of glass from these guys. Get some glass. bottles does that get us? I can handle 48 bottles, yeah. I still made a net positive there. I don't even know how. There's another brick going here? No. Does another brick have a place? Debatably, I think I need a chest for nether brick. Actually, let's do it in cherry because I don't have a use for this right now. I'm gonna brew a bunch of fire res. Like, refill you. Refill you. You're up. You are now filled. You are now filled. Oh, you are already filled. And you now got one. Okay. Another word, time. Is there another potion I want to make? Doing a speed potion. It'd actually be cool. And three more bottles. Thank you. just an awkward potion. That's a really good color, actually. I really like that color on the potion. Anyway. Yeah, let's go get some pink wool, I guess. I just remembered I made the bridge. That's kind of embarrassing. Oh, the alley is just chilling there, I guess. Okay. Kidding me with one off. I gotta have like two pink wool in here, right? Once I organized my inventory, oh my god. I need to remember also get some chains. Alright. Everything should be simple enough. When I first started messing around with making music, a lot of instruments like sound the same, and as a result a lot of songs would sound extremely similar. But I've been trying to get better about using like different instrumentation and things, and trying to be a bit more diverse in my selection. There's certainly some staples that you'll notice, but I'm trying to make it so you actually have to listen for them now, as opposed to them just being like thrown in your face. Oh, I forgot that all the friends were just hanging out there. I am not a builder, despite what people may think. I'm really like the knowledge guy when it comes to Minecraft. I'm not particularly good at much, but I do know how to like do everything, basically. I know how to do everything, I just am not the best one at doing. Minecraft, I guess my biggest motivator, my biggest motivator in the game is just seeing what I can do. Because there's always going to be a new idea, right? So there's going to be something to strive for. But what can I achieve? It's not a question of if I can, but when I will. And how everything turns out, I guess. Some of the Plants vs. Zombies songs. I might remove them from the shuffle though, because I did get copyright claimed. They're cool about it and let me use the song. And technically it's a cover, so I shouldn't have gotten really copyright anyway, I guess. But thing that would drive people crazy if they're paying attention is that like most of my songs have different end times, or like there's like a term for it. I don't know what it is though, but like a certain amount of time after the song ends, that's just dead space would be the term. But there's a certain amount of dead space after, you know, each song. I don't know if there's like a standard or anything, but there is not for my songs, because it's really just whatever I feel like. And that's probably gonna make some people upset with me. I don't know if I blame them. I'm excited to play more Hollow Knight on Wednesday. The game's vibe is just very, very good. Just lost an eye vendor for no reason, because I am not smart. I'll take the end to say it. Yeah. I don't know, I love a lot of different platforming elements in games. Like, platformer isn't my favorite genre, but I really like him. Like, just the creativity and level design that they can have. So, I'm very interested in what Hollow Knight is going to do. I know it's not exactly a platformer, it's more of like a Metroidvania, but I'm interested. I hope it doesn't disappoint. See, one of the risky things with constantly introducing new abilities is that you need to make sure every ability feels like it's actually useful and not just used to get from point A to point B. That could be, like, really annoying. If an ability is only used for a specific thing, that's just not cool, you know? Also, every platformer needs to have good bosses and a boss rush. The best platformers have boss rushes, like Kirby. Basically only Kirby, because Kirby's like the only platformer that actually has good bosses, but like, boss rushes are extremely fun, because typically they also come with a built-in timer. And there's, in the case of Kirby, there's like multiple copy abilities you can use, so there's different ways to play through it. And that just provides a replayability factor. It just goes hand in hand with everything else. I honestly think the arena in the Kirby games is one of the greatest additions to any game, like, ever. If your game has good bosses, then make an arena for it. Imagine if, like, Undertale had a boss rush, right? you get to bring in 8 items or whatever. Or like after you like beat the game. I guess it doesn't really fit with Undertale's aesthetic, but like imagine if there was a boss rush. Deltarune could easily do this with the secret bosses at least. Toby Fox probably will never hear this, but a boss rush of all the secret bosses would be great, right? Like, you don't even need to hide some extreme reward behind it. You just need to make it fun. Like, you could hide the best weapons and or armor in the game behind it. Honestly, that would be actually doubly interesting in the case of specifically Deltarune if you had a boss rush. Because you could get a different reward based on how you complete the boss rush. You know, maybe if you, no matter what, you get a certain reward. But if you spare everyone, then you get an additional specific reward. And then if you, you know, kill everyone, you get a specific reward. See, there's so much untapped potential in boss rushes. I think making boss rushes a mandatory part of the main campaign is a bit iffy. It should typically always be side content, but it's almost always good side content, because a boss rush that's included as side content usually has some amount of care and effort put into it, as opposed to ones that are just part of the main campaign. Those ones can get really lazy. So just boss rushes. Do boss rushes. Make them good. And don't do like any cheap tricks either, where like, oh, they just have like insta kills or whatever. It's like, dude. Like, I guess you could super buff the bosses, kind of like the True Arena does in Kirby. But it's never unreasonable. It always builds off of what was already there. I guess RPGs would have that the worst with power creeping bosses, because they just throw up the numbers insanely high. My favorite game of all time is Mario & Rabbids Kingdom Battle, but what it's missing is a boss rush. You can replay the story mode missions, yeah, but there's no actual boss rush. Imagine if there was just, like, an arena, a pretty simple arena, that had, like, all the boss gimmicks built into it in one way or another. Like, that wouldn't be that hard to do, because, Icicle Golem doesn't have a specific gimmick, and Bowser's gimmick is just the hard blocks. So you could just make the arena the same shape as the Bowser final battle arena, and then include some platforms for like the bananas and the spotlights, and that would just be it right there. And then you'd like start off with fighting Parabit Plant, and then just go through the list. Like, they already kind of did that in a lot of different ways. There's, like, the mid-boss mayhem level in, which is one of the final 4 levels that you get. You have to defeat, like, every enemy in the game. Or you have to defeat every mid-boss in the game, like, almost at the same time. Great. And there's like effect boxes everywhere. Not a big fan of the fact that Junior is just locked in the timeout corner. But You could argue they did it better in the secret cave area in World 4, where they have like the one part where you fight all five of the mini bosses, not including the trio. Still, though, there was missed potential there. Like, all the boss rush needed to give you at that point would have just been, like, an absurd number of coins. And maybe the final remaining skill orbs that you need to fully upgrade all the skill trees. Like, to get absolutely everything. That's not completely necessary. I don't know. God. I always forget that Sparks of Hope is a sequel to Kingdom Battle. Because it plays nothing like Kingdom Battle and is worse in every single conceivable way. But that is just me. I'd actually like to talk to somebody who thinks that Sparks of Hope is better than Kingdom Battle. Because they're factually wrong, but I want to hear them be factually wrong and their reasons for being factually wrong. Honestly, I kind of want to make a game just for the sole fact of including, or the sole purpose of including a boss rush. Also, the fact that nobody, like, no PBZ games have had boss rushes. Absolutely criminal. I guess PBZ2 modding is limited because PopCap code is spaghetti, but like, come on, man. There's that whole free melee movement a while back. Free PBZ2, man. Like, the community is trying its hardest. I think I need to repair this and then go get some deep slate. But I need to finish this segment first. Oh, also, as for why the end of summer motif is in Cattail and is off key from the rest of the song, I have no clue. I know why literally every other part of the song is here. I don't know why the end of summer bit is there. I guess I really liked it or something. There is so much to go off of. I always get this one mixed up with Conflict in Space, both of which need a retooling. First of all, they both need to be more distinct. Well, they are kind of distinct, but I think the reason that they're so similar to me is because the beginnings are similar and that they serve similar purposes. This one needs to have like a much darker tone. I'm half tempted to go back out and get my final Wither Skull. But I kind of want the bunker to be done before I start fighting any Withers. Also, I'm gonna need 4 beacons, so even if I did get a Wither, I'd only be able to get one of the beacons. But I think we all know which perk I'd choose. Sapphire Falls also, I've been working on retooling it. Because Sapphire Falls is another really old one. I like it a lot, it's just a bit awkward, if that makes sense. There's just something about Sapphire Falls that's like a bit off, you know? I think Malachite is probably okay. Tourmaline definitely needs to be redone. That one needs some help. I always thought Tourmaline was the weakest of the three, but also, I never put the falls motif in any of my Cattail songs, which is interesting. I really should have in 2021, as opposed to the end of summer, but I guess end of summer ties more into like the RSV1 aesthetic, so maybe I was playing some like 5D chess there. Thank you. I don't remember the lyrics to this one. It's been way too long. Like, I'm gonna pull up the lyrics to Malachi, though, when that one comes on. Tourmaline lyrics time. Can I pull them up? Thank you. That felt good. That felt really good to sing. I'm not actually like a good singer or anything, but you know, I try. Potentially. Can't sing too loud because it's like, you know, past 11 at night. So it's like talk singing. That's what we're left with. Can't tell Malachi Falls is a song from Mew Mew. One of the characters featured on the emotes. And they're cute. And a killer, but they're cute. Dude, I'm like at the bottom of the world. How can I hear lightning? I really should grab some water. My throat is very dry now. Once again, I am at the bottom of the world. Diamonds are gonna get on accident. know, what's funny is that if I got enough wither skills for a beacon, it wouldn't even be that useful. I just put it in my base for the slight speed boost. And that'll be it. Having a portable one would be nice. Why they added tough to the game if they weren't gonna add any like actual purpose for it other than decoration. Like diorite, andesite, and granite at least have slabs and stairs and polished versions with their own slabs and stairs. Like come on, they do something. Also, they just look like way better. I might want to remake this one, I'm not sure yet. I kind of want to do this one in with the Megalovania sound font. Something very charming about the more electric side of it. Section clear. Five diamonds. Not bad. Actually, I can probably just leave that there. For a second, I thought that was emerald ore, and I got excited. Finding an amethyst geode that I could, like, infinitely farm amethyst off of would be great. Still got a ways to go. Oh yeah, redesign that subject A. I'll be covered. Because, guess what's getting the song tomorrow? Close. sense. We did it. We saved the world. Actually, now that I'm thinking about it, because I have a specific idea of what I want to do with this one in particular. I want to make all of them a lot more distinct and not have them all follow the same formula. So, oh, it's almost time for a new Legends song. Just a couple months. This one's getting its official release the week before the anniversary. And then the 2024 version will debut the week after this one. I think the 2024 version might be even shorter than this one, but we'll see. Thank you. Ah. Well, that is full. If I thought it was faster, I'd go through the nether, but I don't think it's faster. Redstone blocks. Now I get some diamond blocks too. Look at this. I need like 3 stacks of iron blocks for the beacon. I have that. I definitely have that. Copper, coal, leather armor. I probably could smelt some copper. I don't have a lot of rock. What is this? Oh, that's blackstone. That's right. I'm gonna make like an actual bedroom for myself on the second floor. Because I need one. I'm gonna make some hanging signs and see how they look. Oh, I have some oak hanging signs. What is this? If you want, what is this? South? I think I moved all the dyes. Did I? I need two yellow dye. Should be in the flowers then. Concrete. Melon farm, pumpkin farm, potions lab. Oh, she could like bunch them together. Okay. I think I know what that means we need to do. Yep. You need six? Oh, you get six, though. Okay. So that's very expensive. We also need the, West wing, the north wing is here. This would be the east wing. Now let's get some glow ink. I'm running low on glow ink, so I need to get more of that. What are the colors of the wings? I'm pretty sure I'm gonna need these. And probably that. Let's just get two of those. What are the colors of the wings? I think lime is one of them, which means we need green. I have a cactus. Over here again. There we go. I actually want to check the colors. So that is magenta, cyan, lime, yellow. Because we need another cactus green. Thank you. first the magenta. It's purple. Light blue. Okay, so cyan, check. Lime, check. Get magenta. Pink. You need pink. I wish they gave some of the dyes different colors. Oh wait, we need two of each. Oh yeah, they changed how bats look, huh? Magenta goes here. So this is west. There we go. am liking this. Face. No bets. I could probably also add like a directory. I think I'm gonna call it here. Progress was made. And until next time. Hey, nope. Bad song. Get out of here. See you next time. Cattail, signing off. Bye.